Okay, welcome to our 53rd Emuna class in our wonderful, wonderful studio in Yerushalayim. We have the pleasure sitting here with us this week, this special week, Yosef Daniel and Rabbi Yaakov. They're together going to inspire us, and we're going together, thank God, with the Rav, Rav Shalom Oreh Shliter in his wonderful studio, Yerushalayim HaKodesh, and our wonderful translator, Reb Ralph Cohen. Last week, the intro that I gave did get cut off a little bit because of how fantastic we had the wonderful intro from Nissen Black, and we give him big respects. We had a wonderful music session with him, with his current videos going live, and also a special premiere of Lifted, which you can check out now on all our platforms. Very big inspiration and a lot of wonderful feedback so far on that song from Nissen Black. We're going to go into a intro again just to go over what we missed last week. It did come out on Instagram Live and audio, but didn't come out on the general feed. So we're going to give a big refuah shleima to Rav Dayan Elgod, who's still not available to translate because he's still not feeling 100%. So wish him a full refuah shleima. Rav Elchanan Shalom, I'm not sure his mummy's name. Anyone know?
Shoshana Bene.
Okay, so the Rav has already said the name, and with that, we should have a full shleima for Rav Dayan Elgod, and we'll see him back here in the studio. It's Bekorav Mamish. We welcome everyone online to Eretz Yisrael with so many inspired followers. It's really, thank God, the classes are going out there in a big way, and it's thanks to you guys for sharing Emunah Global. Blessings to our special guests, Yosef Daniel and Yaakov and Emunah staff and all, to the full healing of all, to be rid of corona in all forms. Everyone should have safe flights. Whoever needs to get to America and other locations should be able to go there. And please God, the government should open up the world to full healing, and all those working on this should be successful. Amen. These classes are for elevation to the pure special soul of Gedaliah's son, Yerachmu Daniel Ben Gedaliah. We did mention last week, and it got cut off, that Gedaliah kindly donated 150 Gardens of Gratitude Sfarim to a shiur that he gave. We recommend you guys also getting those books, ordering them online and giving them out in your classes and your communities, just like Gedaliah Fenster so kindly did. We appreciate your dedication to our Muna class, to the Rav's teachings. We wish you a good week, a healthy rest of winter, and to share Emunah Global all. Now, first, we want to say a big thank you to all the feedback questions. Everyone reminded again about the Rav's Emunah exercises. We have a new growth in that with the 2022 sessions coming out. New Wonders of Gratitude Garden Book of Emunah, and also the campaign booklet we already mentioned last week has been updated thanks to Ralph Cohen's translation, and please God, there'll be another second one coming soon. Stay tuned. I'm very happy now to give this feedback for the opportunity of watching and learning from Rav Oreh and Nissen Black. This is from last week's class. Shalom from Brazil. Just can't get enough of Nissen. He is the inspiration of our great times to truly lift us, based on the song Lifted. Baruch Hashem, Todah. I feel the connection. It's so good, Baruch Hashem. Fire and Shalom. Shalom said to the Rav. This was from our holy brother, Yoni Gabali. He said a big Shalom. And lifted, gifted, and definitely thrifted with Hashem doing the saving. Someone did a nice rhyme over there. Go bro and fam, blessings of Emunah music, Dr. Eliezer Gutterman. He's one of our supporters in Staten Island. Bring the holy brothers together, Emunah always. Yeah, you can check out, he did a nice song with Nissim as well. He's doing some great content, Eliezer Gutterman. Hashem is kind, thank you for your teachings, bendiciones.
Blessings.
Ellie Goldsmith's weekly class. See, I get some Spanish people there as well. I'm very grateful for these videos. It strengthens me. Many blessings and love. You inspire me. You radiate such joy and positivity. Thank you so much. May Hashem bless you in abundance. That was in reference to Rabbi Yonatan Galed. Once again, we'd love to have him back in English, but you can follow him in Espanol. Great organization, Breslov English. Keep it up. Baruch Hashem. Ellie G. Emunah class, that was on my class. This was fantastic. Thank you. I needed this today. This was lifted in the studio. Rav Ralph Cohen's classes, thank you for sharing Rabbi Nachman's stories. They are amazing. So thank God we do have a growing amount of classes. We just had a wonderful clip from the Rav himself. Dalia Fenster's classes are going up. And we want to thank you, Hashem, for everything you give us, all our team, the MC, Rav Ralph, the guests, the translate, and all the previous and coming classes, and we have such great energy. So let's go to our guest, sincere soul with smiles and talents, will help us. Let's go with Yosef Daniel and his wonderful percussionist.
You are the maker of all the matter. You never slumber, you're beyond measure. We'll sing forever, you're our creator. We shatter from the mountaintops, you're higher than the images of other gods. We shatter from the mountaintops, you're higher than the images of other gods. We shatter from the mountaintops, you're higher than the images of other gods. We shatter from the mountaintops, you're higher than the images of other gods. Kadosh, 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 ata kadosh, vision ta kadosh. Ufushim kol yom yeledu chasela, ata kadosh, vision ta kadosh. Ufushim kol yom yeledu chasela.
Thank you, Hashem.
Thank you. So, our first question. Yes, please. Yeah.
Actually, Ralph, question number one we spoke about last week. So, want to bring it up again?
It's up to you.
דיברנו על ההתמודדות הזאת בקטימה. עוד פעם?
לא, אפשר לדבר עכשיו שמות, השואבים, אני יכול לדבר עכשיו קצת.
All right, the rabbi is going to start off with a small mini class before we get into the question and answer form.
עכשיו שבועות, השבועות, זה השבוע השני ששובבים תת, אז כן.
We're already holding in the second week of Shavavim Tat, which is a very special time.
Sharizal amar shebuot ele hem sugalim od od tikun habrit shebuot ele.
Now the Holy Arizal taught us that these weeks, these following weeks, are auspicious to work on and to gain personal purity.
Ki b'shebuot ele shem sapprim al yitziat Mitzrayim. אז זה זמן שיש בו הערה, העולם מתנהל לפי הפרשת השבוע.
Because during these following weeks we say the story of the exodus of Egypt, and what happens in the world goes by the Torah, the weekly Torah portion of the week.
אז לכן זה שבועות שממש מסוגלים. ומה זה... זה מה זה יש בזה השפעה לבן אדם גם למצאת הסיבוב, גם לשלום בית, גם להיפקד בבנים צדיקים.
So, the effect of these weeks, they take part in your personal life, in your, if a person needs to find a soulmate, with your marital peace, and to merit to have children, whoever is lacking children.
אז באמת, נוהגים כל מיני דברים בעולם, שווה שעושים הרבה תשומות בזמן הזה.
There are many people that actually fast, many, many fast during these weeks.
רבי נחמן מברסלב ביקר עלינו, ונתן לנו תיקון קל.
Rabbi Nachman of Breslov, he had mercy on us, and he gave us an easy way, an easy rectification.
שצריכים פעם אחת בשבוע,
once a week,
לא לאכול משהו מן החי.
Not to eat something that comes from a living being, a living animal.
לא לאכול בשר, דגים, ביצים, חלבי.
No meat, no chicken, no fish, no eggs.
שום דבר מן החי. אסור לאכול. לא אוכלים.
So you go on sort of like a vegan diet, so to speak.
יש הרבה מה לאכול.
You have a lot we can eat still. Fruits, vegetables. You could have anything with the flour is acceptable. You could eat, but it's take it down a step. It's a bit easier for us. Just don't eat something that's have like a vegan diet. Now, during these weeks, we say more Tehillim, more Psalms, than we say during the rest of the year. There's also a special book that the rabbi merited to write, which is called The Garden of Purity. This is a very special time to take the book and start to read it and learn it. And the most important thing in the world is to love every single Jew.
בתורה, בהשיח השבועת השם ברך, עם ישראל לא יודעים מהמצווה הזאת.
I tell Hashem, how could it be that the most valuable and important mitzvah in the whole Torah is so hidden from the people? How could this be?
הכי גדולה בתורה.
It's the greatest mitzvah, the greatest commandment in the whole Torah.
אתם רוצים לדעת מה המצווה, כן?
Of course, everyone's getting curious. You want to know which mitzvah is the rabbi talking about.
המצווה זה ואהבת לרעך כמוך.
This following mitzvah is to love your fellow Jew as yourself.
זה כתוב בחומש.
It's brought down in the Chumash, in the Torah itself, the five books of Moses.
זה אחד מתרג מצוות.
And this is one of the 613 mitzvot.
פתחתי מסתכלים עליי ואומרים, מה קרה לרב הזה? מי לומק את המצווה הזאת?
You hear this, you say, what's this rabbi talking about? What's the rabbi talking about? Who never heard of this mitzvah? We all have heard of this mitzvah. The rabbi doesn't have a siddur. He doesn't have a prayer book.
Kol siddur katuv b'tav kol yom. Arei ani mekabel atz mitzvot aseh shel va'aret la'aretz kamocha.
Every prayer book, you open up to the morning prayers. Right before the morning prayers, it says, I hereby accept upon myself to love every single Jew as myself.
Arei ani ohev kol echad v'echad b'mitzvot.
And I hereby love every single Jew like my own self, my own soul and essence. How could it be that you say that the people don't know of this commandment? Let me ask you. You really say that you recognize and you know this mitzvah?
אני מקבל עצמי מצוות עשה של ואהבת לרעך, הוא דומה לאחד שכותב, חותם על צ'ק, והוא לא יודע מה הסכום שכתוב שם איזה סכום, לא יודע.
When you're saying this in the morning, that I accept upon myself ואהבת לרעך כמוך, that I love everybody like myself, you know what you compare it to? You compare it to a fellow that takes out his checkbook and he starts to sign on a check, but he doesn't know the amount that's written on the check.
You might תסתכל על הסכום לפני שאתה חותם, תסתכל.
Before you start signing on a check, look to see what you're signing on.
כתוב שם מיליארד דולר.
It says $1 million.
לא מיליון, מיליארד.
Billion.
Billion. Billion דולר כתוב. ואתה חותם,
מתי... You're just signing like it's nothing.
מתי יש לך לשלם?
You have that money in your bank account.
מה אתה חותם?
What are you signing for?
שאתה אומר, אני מקבל עצמי, צוות עשה, שבאהבת, אתה יודע מה אתה מקבל? אתה מקבל. לא לסנוע שום יהודי, לא לקנב שום יהודי, לא לדבר על שום יהודי, לא לקבל שום יהודי, והרשימה ארוכה.
Or it says, the truth is, when you're saying that I hereby accept upon myself to love every single Jew, you're accepting upon yourself not to hate any Jew. You're accepting upon yourself not to be jealous of any Jew. You're accepting upon yourself not to speak lashon hara, evil speech, or accept it, to listen, to hear lashon hara about any Jew. You have a long, long list. Rabbi has a long list.
And you're
accepting upon yourself on a positive note that you're going to love every single Jew just as much as you love yourself. You're going to honor every single Jew. You're
going
to be happy with every single Jew. You want your fellow Jew to succeed and to be happy when he succeeds and to pray for every single Jew just as much as you would pray for yourself. And the list is much, much longer. Yeah, $1 billion you're signing off.
Ara
said it's a very, very long list of things that you're accepting upon yourself. So the truth is that the Jewish people don't really know what type of mitzvah you're accepting. They don't know what the mitzvah means.
ואם עם ישראל היו יודעים את המצווה הזאת, לא היה שום גלות, שום צרה לא היה בעולם, בעם ישראל ולא בעולם.
If we would know the true meaning of this mitzvah, there would be no exile. We wouldn't be in exile. There would not be any suffering in the world.
בשביל מה צריכים בכלל לדבר שלא לשנוא, לא לדבר על שנאה, בשביל מה צריכים לדבר עם זה?
Or he says, why do we have to speak about negative, not to hate and not to speak evil speech? Because you're obligated to love every single Jew. Does the rabbi have to tell me, don't speak evil about your own child? Don't hate your child? And I look at the rabbi like he's funny, like, you don't have to tell me these things, these are natural things. Rabbi says, you're not doing a favor to anybody, you're not doing a favor to the rabbi. You have an obligation to love every single Jew. The rabbi is just teaching us what it is and how to fulfill it. The rabbi is telling us to send your commitments to Eli, to the rabbi. You had got a nice list last week. The rabbi holds it with him, very dear to him, these names of everyone that accepted upon themselves to do a half hour of personal prayer to add love and unity in the Jewish people in the world. Rabbi said he has a special list that's already small names on a lot on one paper. Said he still has the paper from last week of the English names. The rabbi keeps it with him.
אז לכן, אתה חייב לקיים, אתה, הבאת, חייבים לקיים את המצווה הזאת, זה נאהוב כל יהודי כמו שאתה אוהב את עצמך. זה מה שכתוב.
You have to understand that you, every single boy, every single girl, every single adult has to accept upon themselves to love every single Jew just as much as they love themselves.
אז אתה לא יכול, תתפלל כל יום מיליון שעות, כל יום, מיליון שעות, שתזכיר קיים את המצווה הזאת.
If you're not fulfilling this and if you can't do it, so you have to pray and ask Hashem, help me to get to this level to understand and to be able to fulfill this positive commandment.
לכן אנחנו מלמדים את כולם שיתפללו חצי שעה ביום שכל עם ישראל יהיה להם אהבת ישראל.
Therefore, we're teaching that you should pray for a half hour that every single Jew should have אהבת ישראל, should have love for every single Jew.
כשאתה מתפלל שעם ישראל יהיה להם אהבת ישראל, אתה ראשון קבל אהבת ישראל.
Because you know who gets first Avat Yisrael when you pray for everybody? You yourself. We have a first one that came out in English.
And
we have more. We have a second one in the works. And the rabbi is working on a third booklet. So everyone should get a hold of these booklets, to learn them, to do with the solutions that are brought down in the booklets, to spread them, to teach the content. Rabbi says that there was a light that was brought down into this world, and this light can chase away all the darkness. The Rabbi is ready for another song.
Yosef Daniel and Yaakov, thank you.
Told me about the time you made Jupiter and Mars. You held me close with your voice, I was mesmerized. You are, you'll be the one, you opened up my eyes. The years continued passing, your promises were lasting. I left my father's home to follow you, I never doubted. I spoke to everyone of how I thought you were the one. And even though they doubted us, I knew we'd just begun. You're with me in the flames, you'll be with me in the end. The whole world will know your name, and our love will still remain. You make me strong when I am weak. Now everyone will finally see, you're my glorious friend. You're my glorious friend. Cause even though I know that you're light years away, I know your light shines when I feel afraid, my friend. You're my glorious friend. Cause even though I know that you're light years away, I know you love me and you'll always be my friend. Promises were lasting. I left my father's home to follow you, I never doubted. I spoke to everyone of how I thought you were the one. And even though they doubted us, I knew we'd just begun. You're with me in the flames, you'll be with me in the end. The whole world will know your name, and our love will still remain. You make me strong when I am weak. Now everyone will finally see, you're my glorious friend. You're my glorious friend. 'Cause even
you love me and you'll always be my friend. You'll always be my friend. Oh, we have a friend in you. Yes, we have a friend in you. We have an eternal friend, it's you. Hashem Yitbarach, you're my glorious friend. Oh, you're my glorious friend.
Wow, wow. So we have to thank Yosef Danil coming special to our studio in Yerushalayim, all the way from Beit Shemesh. What an awesome, awesome song. I really felt the love there, especially after the words from the Rav. Once again, remind everyone, get these campaign booklets out there. Get Emunah Global, Avos Yisrael, Avos people. We love all people, to make the message global, to bring it alive through loving others and praying for others. And we want to also mention that Yosef Danil has many songs, thank God, that he's put out recently, including a beautiful song in Spanish with Nissim Black. Is that correct?
Milagros.
Yeah, Milagros. And that was a song that we put in our Instagram stories. We've been sharing it around. It's a big, big track that he did together with Nissim Black. And he's done some other collaborations, something with Yoni Gabali, one of our guests as well. And I'm sure he has a long list of songs. Check out all his links, especially the Instagram one we put there. Build up a following for him so he can keep getting his music out there. His Emunah Music Global. We really appreciate that, as he's actually our most attended guest. He's been here the most, more than all the other musicians and speakers and creators that we've blessed with Unity Bookings to bring into our Emunah studio. We've had the blessing of Yosef Danil more than all of those, and we say a big thank you to him and his wife as well for dedicating time to come out of his work schedule and other things to be here most consistently when we need him. And it's a big thank you to you. We don't take it for granted. We want to ask if you have any words to say just towards the Rav. And also Yaakov, maybe just a little bit of chizuk towards what the Rav just said about Avos as well. And then hopefully we'll get into the questions once the Rav comes back.
100%. Thank you so much for giving me the opportunity to be here.
Pleasure.
It's a big zechut, it's a big honor. And it's definitely something that is also very, very special. Very special time here to be with the Rav. And just to reiterate what the Rav was saying is that, you know, Any civilization, any organization, any group of people that in the world history, the only reason they have success is because of unity, and that we see it, that we know it just from world history. But Mamash Dafka Am Yisrael being the nation that represents the unity of the Shem Yud-Kei Vav-Kei, the Shem Hashem. And the unity of the world with the Creator, the creation with the Creator, we mamash need to be unified and have a strong togetherness and love, pure love. And speaking to myself strongly that in these times that we're being tested, we're being given some tremendous tests on a personal level. It's very important to stay strong and to stay focused and to understand that it's the little things that can change the whole path, you know, that we're on. One moment of anger, one moment of anything can change the whole picture. And and right now, because of the frustration that the world is experiencing, we were talking about this before we started, that the whole world is experiencing a level of stress, a level of frustration. We must understand that's the test, and this is all in preparation from what we believe and what we see it. What we see is a preparation for the Geula Shelema. Bezat Hashem, it should be soon, and it should be in a good way, and only love can bring that. And I believe also music can be a very, very big tool for bringing people together and for we're getting the love that we need. The Rav is playing guitar now. Yes. There you go. Music is a huge tool. It's a huge thing. So Zat Hashem, we should see more music. There should be many artists, many artists that are encouraged by what they're seeing, by other musicians. You know, we should bring more love.
Man. Beautiful, beautiful. Wow.
That's a good. I feel like my guitar just got blessed.
Amen. Wow. So let's go to the questions now. The Rav's back. Thank you, Yosef Danil. Thank you, Rav, for translating. So nice.
Sure. We spoke about Thursday night class in Chulon. We spoke about marriage. Rabbi spoke about marriage, that we want to heal the marriage. So the person is asking, how can I heal my marriage if my wife is cold to me? What can I do with Hashem to cause her to return to me? Which give you a little background. The rabbi spoke about the idea of a mirror for all those that don't know the rabbi's book. So, Shalim Po'alav, על בסיס מה שדיברנו בהשיר בחולון לגבי האיש ואישה, יש אישה שהיא מתנהגת בקר לבעל. איך בן אדם יכול לשנות את הקשר שלו עם הבורא, על ידי זה יהיה לו את ה...
כל כך פשוט. תחמם.
Rabbi said, you have to warm up your relationship with Hashem.
יעבוד Hashem בהתלהבות, באהבה, בהתלהבות, בחום, בחשק. שיעבוד, ודאי אין... אישה זה מראה של הבעל. מראה של היחס שלו עם הקדוש ברוך
הוא. A person's wife is their mirror for their relationship between them and Hashem. So this person is asking if his wife is acting cold to him. The rabbi says the solution is that he should serve Hashem. He should be excited for the service of Hashem. He should warm up his connection between him and Hashem. All right.
Some flowers maybe might help.
Tachim lechot Shabbat.
Shabbat.
כן, זה מה שאתה אומר זה שהוא יעשה בשביל אשתו, ודאי שצריכים לעשות בשביל אשתו. ואנחנו אומרים שאדם לעשות בשביל החשבוך הוא. כי אישה זה מראה שלו מה בקשר להיחס שלו עם החשבוך הוא.
I said, of course it's important to get some chocolate, some flowers, which we got to mention here. But that's between your personal work between you and your wife. But let's say for your, what we're really trying to work on, it shows us that there's a real problem between, there's a some sort of miscommunication between you and your creator, you and Hashem. So that's what the rabbi is coming from that angle to explain the idea that a wife is a mirror between of your relationship with Hashem. So that if a person is ready and he wants to work, that's the way to work. So if we each loved every Jew like our own selves, Mashiach would be here. Or would we just help elevate mankind? Maybe we're not doing such a good job. This is everything the rabbi is working on. Shalim Parav, Im anachnu yohav kol yehudi, az Mashiach amul liyot pa.
Nachon, evet.
Anachnu lo osim et avodah kmo shesarich.
Nachon, bichlal lo mdabrim bichlal me'avat Yisrael.
Rabbi said, they're not really talking about the idea of loving every Jew in the world.
Tamid מדברים, אם כבר מדברים לא יהיה שנאה, לא יהיה קנאה, לא יהיה לשון הרע. שמה בכלל, לא צריכים בכלל להגיע לזה. מי אהבה, כבר לא צריכים בכלל להגיע לכל זה.
Rabbi says that in the world, there's no one speaking about the idea of love. They might be, if they wake up and they say, oh, we have to change, they'll say we have to work on not hate, we work on hatred, or to work on lashon hara, and things on the negative side. Rabbi says, go to the positive side. And if there's love, then you won't have all the issues that come out from a lack of love.
Afilu nafil afilu madam, okay? Ulo daber lashon hara because he's afraid.
let's say a person, he doesn't speak evil speech. He doesn't have Lashon Hara in his life because he's scared of the sin. He has fear of heaven and he doesn't sin because he knows this sin is so grave. It's like the three cardinal sins. Like it's like adultery. It's like murder. It's like immorality. But this is on such a low level.
Rabbi
said, let's go to a higher level. Why don't I speak evil about him? Because I love him. Why won't I accept any Lashon Hara that someone tells me about this person? Because I love him. There is a person goes from that angle of without working on his love, there's no way that you'll be clean, there's no way that you won't fall to the sins of Lashon Hara, because we're surrounded with so much all around us. We hear new things every single day. It's almost, it's impossible, the rabbi says, to hear Lashon Hara and to accept it without working on yourself and having a half hour of to add love and unity. The rabbi said he could testify about himself, and we all know that the rabbi works on himself.
Like,
I said, before he started working on Avat Yisrael for a half hour every single day, as much as he worked on himself, small little points of Lashon Hara would enter his heart. They would enter into his being. So when a person works on loving every Jew, his mouth and his ears are clean for sure. But the main thing we want, and the main thing that you merit, to have a clean heart and a clean mind. They're pure. And this is such a great present.
Rabbi
said, this past Shabbat, he understood something, another important, valuable lesson on this topic. It's brought down that somebody that does not have jealousy towards another person, after 120 years when he passes away, his goof, his body stays whole. So if that's for somebody that just is not jealous, what about somebody that loves his fellow Jew? What about the one that has full of love and unity between everybody? Not only is he not jealous, he's on a much higher level. He has love towards every single Jew. It's the greatest gift. You have a good eye, you get a good heart. Rabbi Nachman of Reza teaches us that one who has love with great, someone that prays with Mesirut Nefesh, with great devotion for every single Jew, he merits humility.
Rabbi
says, if you pray every single day for a half hour, that's called great devotion. That's called Mesirut
Nefesh.
The greatest level that a person could reach in this world is to merit to have wholesomeness and to have complete Avat Yisrael, to have complete love towards every Jew.
קבלו עצמכם, את פרק אמת ישב ביום על אבת ישראל, ואת מסירות השמות, שם 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 אמא, רב אלי היקר, הוא יביא לי את השמות, ואני אמפה לכם כל יום.
Rabbi says, accept this half hour, send Eli your name, your mother's name, and the rabbi will get your names, and he will pray for you every single day. Rabbi says, you don't really need his prayers. He said, but nothing bad will come out from it.
Wow, 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 guys, you hearing? Are you internalizing the importance of these classes to get the Avos Yisrael and that love of all people at Global? That means joining us with a campaign, sending in your names. You've got the in the description, my email, easy to contact me, DM me. It's all the different ways to reach out, to make these classes alive and interactive. But it needs your prayers. It needs your dedication. We want to thank again the Rav and Rav Rafael for translating the Rav so beautifully. And we also want another song to climax this class. So Yosef Danil, Unity Amuna Music, going global with rounding off 2021 with 2022. A new energy. And a thanks to all our guests till now. The GAN, 53rd class. We've been in the garden together. And our most attended guest is here to inspire us with more music. Thank you.
Can you hear your people calling? Atash me'at the filah kovet. The time has come to read you moss again. Enod milvado, we trust you're in control. Hashem Elokeinu, Hashem Echad. We shout it from the rooftops. Higi hazman geulah shelanu, higi hazman geulah shelanu. Hashem tzevakosh shemau. Higi hazman geulah shelanu, higi hazman geulah shelanu. Hashem tzevakosh shemau. Hashem tzevakosh shemau. Y te elevamos con la adoración. Somos tu fiel y única nación. Juntos clamamos hoy a ti. Avinu shebashamayim. Higi hazman geulah shelanu. Higi hazman geulah shelanu. Hashem tzevakosh shemo. Higi hazman geulah shelanu. Higi hazman geulah shelanu, Hashem tzevakosh shemo, Hashem tzevakosh shemo, anachnu lo mefached, ki ata yitzaranu, ki ata yitzaranu, anachnu lo mefached, ki ata yitzaranu.
Attention, Banu, attention. לנו בת ישראל במשלימות לאהוב כל יהודי ממש כמו הבן שלי תן בנו ותן לנו בת ישראל בשלמות לאהוב כל יהודי ממש כמו הבן שלי ותן בנו ותן לנו בת ישראל בשלמות לאהוב כל יהודי ממש כמו את עצמי ותן בנו ותן לנו בת ישראל בשלמות לאהוב כל יהודי כנפשי ומאודי תן בנו ותן לנו בת ישראל בשלמות לאהוב כל יהודי בכל נפשי בכל מאודי תן בנו ותן לנו בת ישראל בשלמות לאהוב כל יהודי ממש כמו הבן שלי תן בנו ותן לנו בת ישראל בשלמות לאהוב כל יהודי כי מי שאוהב את השם דברך הוא אוהב כל יהודי אתה לא יכול להגיד אני אוהב את השם אבל את הבנים שלו אני אוהב את האבא את הבנים שלו אני שונא מי שאוהב את השם מי שאוהב לאדם לא יכול להגיד אני אוהב את השם אם הוא לא אוהב כל יהודי הוא לא יכול להגיד
for one that says I love Hashem it can't be that you love Hashem without loving his children you can't say oh Hashem I love but his nation the Jewish people I don't love that can't doesn't work like that
מי שאוהב את השם אוהב כל יהודי
someone who loves Hashem loves every single Jew
תן בנו ותן לנו אהבת ישראל בשלמות לאהוב כל יהודי ממש כמו הבן שלי תן בנו ותן לנו אהבת ישראל בשלמות לאהוב כל יהודי בכל נפשי בכל מאודי ותן בנו ותן לנו אהבת ישראל בשלמות אהוב את השם ברך עם כל יהודי ויהודי
Do a final song. Let's go. Let's go, Yosef the Nail. You nigga.
Bye.
come on. Yeah. We're at the climax of this special class. We do have a few more questions. Maybe we'll save it for next week. Yeah, I think that's it. Thank you. Please send your names. The Rav has asked you again and again. We invite, please God, Yosef Daniel back to our Amunah class. We'll be joining Amunah class 54 of Yosef Aaron, a chazan, a special chazan with his son. We're looking forward to host more special guests, but most importantly, join together. We're getting Amunah global. Amen.
Amen. Amen.